so silly. Wow, that was a close one. Hi guys, welcome back. I'm genuinely so buzzing to sit down and film these videos. I wanted to start off by saying I love you guys who subscribe. And even those 64% of you who don't subscribe and still watch my videos, guess what? I'm feeling good today, so I still love you. So today I'm going to be talking about fashion things that you will regret buying. I have so many things that I regret buying, and I'm going to do a video soon about the things that I do regret buying, because there's definitely many of them. And let me tell you, this hat is one of the things that I do not regret buying. Oh wait, no, I didn't even buy it. Just to let you guys know, I have a video out every single Sunday and maybe one every now and then midweek, so stick around because you don't want to miss it. Now the first one, please don't click off. You're gonna think I'm a basic girly after I say this, but I promise you, I'm literally 30 seconds time we'll move on to another topic. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Anything leopard print, don't buy it. Wait until the trend has died out, because it will, because these girls are going to be realizing that they actually all of a sudden don't like fur, or they don't like leopard or whatever. But stick to your guns. I'm gonna leave it for a few years and it's gonna come back. And this whole grandma chic thing that I was talking about in my trend prediction video, that's how I'm gonna be wearing it. Grandma chic, not in a Pinterest girl kind of way. So stick around. But for now, genuinely, you will regret buying those Adidas shoes. Disgusting. Those Adidas shoes, boy. Don't if you're watching this video and you have those shoes, click off. I'm joking, I actually don't click off because I need some views. I genuinely don't care what people wear. Now, I'm not going to take credit for this one. I saw Lainey saying this in her YouTube video. She said, anything trendy in more than one way, and I could not agree more. She gave the example of, say, ballet pumps. They're already pretty trendy, let alone if they're square toe ballet pumps, like actual ballet pumps, and they're leopard print, and say they have some like grommet details on. That, crazy, don't do that. I thought that was a good point. That's not crossed my mind before. I think trendy in one way, like, we can allow, but when it's trendy in more than one way, it's just like, whoa, 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 you're gonna get bored of that real quick. Okay, this one is something that I'm not very good at, but don't buy anything that you didn't think about before you saw it, other than if you're like thrifting or... But even when you're thrifting, you should always have in mind already what you're kind of looking for. But if you see something that's like hundreds of pounds and you didn't already have it in your mind, then do you need it that much? Say if you like see something on a website and you're like, oh, I have to get this now before it goes. It's like, well, take two steps back. Did you ever think about this before today? Has it been on your mind before or not? Because my husband Jude has a list on his phone of literally like everything he wants, so specific. It might even be a spreadsheet, but he even has like the links to the exact one, the sizes, like he'll know everything about that brand and that material. And I just think that's honestly the way to be, because I know that when he does get a piece into his wardrobe, it like means so much more to him. I don't even know if that makes sense what I just said, but you guys get the point. By the way, the song Postman Pattern's Little Black and White Cat is running through my head while I'm filming this. Yes, and it has been driving me crazy the whole time. Okay, anything non-functional. Now, I didn't say we can't have a little bit of fun. I'm not saying that, but I mean more spending like unneeded money, or if you can't actually afford something and you're buying it, but it's not even functional. It's like, should you really be doing that? Now, I'm not saying like everything I buy ever is functional, because that's definitely not the case, but I do think about that. Say if like I'm buying a jacket, like I always look if it has pockets, because me being realistic, me, I do like a handbag, but sometimes I know I just want to have pockets big enough to fit in the things that I need to. Yeah, things that aren't functional, say like off top of my head, these Gucci platform loafers, come on now, and these crochet shoes, come on now, that's not practical, that's not gonna last. Find yourself some big old sturdy boots and they'll stand the test of time. Okay, next one, try to avoid, because I know it's not possible with everything you'll ever buy, but do try to avoid buying fast fashion things or even bad quality things, because it's so hard sometimes figure out if it is bad quality or not, especially when you're thrifting. How else are you supposed to have a circular wardrobe? Like, it's so important to have a circular wardrobe and things that will stand the test of time and that you can love and it will be loved after you. Otherwise, what's the point? It's like you're being selfish. Like, I don't know if that's so rude to say, but I do. It is like you're being selfish when you just religiously everything Shein. Like, do you not think about any, do you literally not think about anything? Now, I talked more about this. I did like a whole video dedicated to how to stop wasting your money buying clothes. And I talked a little bit about aspirational branding. And I'm just going to mention that quickly, not to fall for it. And don't buy things thinking that, you know, if you buy something, you're going to have this whole another lifestyle. I would say it's all about like romanticizing and not like just being realistic with your lifestyle and not falling for brands, good brand marketing. Next one. I feel like I've always been a hater of this, but I'm gonna say logos. Now, this is a weird one for me because I do actually have some things. Okay, exhibit A, logo, but it's not, it doesn't say Chanel, or it doesn't say hey people like okay, sorry, that's just stevedore. I like a logo in a silly way, and I like a logo when it's not trying to be so serious, like Gucci this, Gucci that. Like, even with brands like Ralph Lauren and things like that, like, girl, unless it's like a piece and I've bought the piece for that reason, or like Vivienne Westwood because I like the piece, not because there's a logo on it, you get me. But I just think brands are like this all the time. One moment this brand's cool, the next moment it's not cool. So brands with logos, just find something more like interesting other than like something with a logo on. And under the topic of this, sorry to be a negative Nancy, but don't buy things with like a single item object on. Okay, let me give you an example. Top with a margarita glass, a top with some dice on, a top with a cherry on, a top with a disco ball on. Do you catch my drift? Now, I have a few tops, particularly at the moment, horsey girl tops. Like, that one in particular, you guys know the one I'm talking about with that horse on it. Now, that is an object, that is an item, but like, wait, is it an object? It's a mammal, but you get my point, right? But that's kind of done more in like a timeless kind of way. I don't know. This one for me is quite tricky. You pick up what I'm putting down with this. Now, the last one I want to talk about is quite funny. I'm not going to say never buy vintage shoes, but all I'm going to say is I have had probably in my life maybe a good 8 pairs of shoes completely die on me because I've bought them secondhand. The soles disintegrate. I've had this with bags too. It's so funny now, whenever I see these certain people, they always ask me if my shoes are gonna fall off, because it happened last time I was with them and I was walking. They were like heeled black, really cool silver hardware looking heeled boots, and I was literally walking and my sock was getting wet because like it was just foot. And I actually still have those boots because I can't get rid of them because they're so pretty. And I'm like, no, I'm gonna get them resold. Just know the risk, because there is a high risk. And I don't know, spending a lot of money on vintage shoes is kind of like, I don't know. You just gotta know the risk, I guess. Anyways, I'm gonna put it in my title for this video, but don't be a sheep, guys. Also, don't listen to me, because I'm literally sat here in like a Post and Pat hat and like, come on now, come on. Let's be real. I really am not one to judge, and I'm never judging. And hopefully I didn't sound too like negative, because I'm not trying to be negative. I'm just trying to talk. Please let me know what you guys thought of this video. I want to make some chainmetal jewelry. I have like little chain things ready to make. So maybe I'll show you if I make anything. I'll see you whenever I see you. Probably on Sunday, but there might be a midweek video if you get lucky. Anyways, see you guys later. Love you. Bye.